Hello there, folks. These are the hands of me, Dan Brown, from sortofinteresting.com. Yes, I'm afraid I'm in the echoey hallway. This is a Scrub GLD DH mounting board. But what we're looking at today in particular is this set of Scrub drum brakes. So then, what exactly are these drum brakes? Well, if we have a proper look, these wheel rims are not part of the set, but I will explain my dilemma and why they're on here now. Now, basically, the brakes themselves consist of this truck that will go on the back of the mounting board, which we'll have a look at in a minute. Basically, you have your classic bike handle at one end of the cord, and then when you squeeze that, it pulls the lever to basically tighten up these brake pads here on the inside of this little disc that you get to attach to your wheel rim. So it fits in just over the end like that. Oh yes, this is only half of the wheel, just for demonstration purposes. Now, these are meant to fit to proper five rim reels wheels that have the holes for the bolts slightly inset. But I haven't been able to find any of those at the minute, so please do not try this at home. I've just used for testing purposes some cable ties to attach it to the inside of the wheel, and obviously it's a bit loose and it's going to rub a bit when it's on the axle, but I thought just to test it out and see how the brakes work, it will hopefully do for a couple of rides. But like I say, please do not try this at home. And well, basically, just like you would with any other truck, these are channel type trucks. You're basically going to stick it on the end of the mounting board over here. And, well, we'll see how it goes right now. So, first things first, and for the sake of ease, I will take the current wheels off. So, now the wheels are off, it's much easier to work with. And, as you can see, hopefully, when I unscrew the big bolt here, and those two, I believe, this is all going to fall into place perfectly for the new trucks with the drum brakes to slot nicely in. Like I say, hopefully. Whew, so that was difficult work and very greasy. And basically just have to unscrew the bolt off that and then try and pull that through the full length of the undercarriage, whatever it's called. So now it's just take these little placeholders for the suspension and put them on the new trucks. One thing of note, just while we're here, as I don't intend to take this apart very often, but you've literally just got all these little bits and pieces on the channel truck suspension that I was quite surprised to see are literally just all, well, just freely around, lounging about inside the springs. Right, so the next step, nearly there, is to get these tyres and inner tubes off the old wheel rims and onto the new ones. And basically, with this, it's a simple case of unscrewing the bolts here, so that the two parts of the wheel rim come apart so that the tyre and inner tube can easily be taken off. And obviously, because you have the bent valve there, you need to have these apart so that you can fit the valve through, so that you've got easy access to obviously inflate and deflate it. Well, that was an awful lot of fiddly work, but as you can see, the brakes are now attached and the wheels are on, so I will clean up this mess, pump up the tyres, and then we'll see how it goes. Right then, folks, we're all ready to go. There is a bracket to fix this part to the board properly, but I'll have a proper look at that and see what I think is the best way to attach it. So, we've got a nice little slope down here. Let's put the old squeezy to the test. Right, we've got some decent speed. Let's give it a go. Works like a charm. Right then, check out sortofinteresting.com for a load more bits and pieces like that. Subscribe to the YouTube channel because there's going to be a lot more mounting boarding to come. I'll see you around soon.